here in life.
Yes, thank you. Good morning, one and all, dear participants. Thank you very much, God Almighty, for this new day. And especially, we are on the last stage of our very good webinar series. I think tomorrow will be the last day on our webinar. So before concluding our webinar, we were very keen on selecting today's topic actually. What kind of topic we have to adopt for prior to the last day. And excuse me. So, to the best of our interest, we have shortlisted our today's topic, self-esteem and self-trust, or in other words, self-trust and self-esteem. The purpose of our entire webinar, the purpose of our entire the series, if you look at the entire series, tomorrow we will have a review session. We will review what are all the things we have discussed in the from July 1st to July 23. The purpose of designing this particular webinar is to improve your self-trust, and that's the way you can improve your self-esteem towards the society, towards your family, towards your surroundings. So today's topic we are having is a very interesting topic, building self-trust and self-esteem. Why we should have a career? Because you want to establish your self-esteem towards your surroundings. It might be your family, it might be your society, it might be your working environment, wherever you want to show you are a reputed personality. What it reflects, you know, that is what we are calling self-esteem actually. How the self-esteem can build, you know, because based on the self-trust what you are having. The purpose of this entire webinar series is to is helping you to improve your self-trust. Thus, you can have a very good self-esteem, positive self-esteem. For discussing this wonderful self-esteem and self-trust topic, today we are having, again we are having Dr. V.S. Meji, Assistant Professor, Associate Professor, Arulanandar College, Department of Commerce, such a wonderful professor. Earlier, she was handling goal setting. She was discussed about different types of goal settings, the ways to adopt goal settings, short-term goals, long-term goals, setting smart goals, plenty of things she was shared actually. And with that great pleasure, with that great enthusiasm, today also I am welcoming again Dr. V.S. Meji to the forum. Ma'am, thank you very much for your presence. On behalf of St. John the Latter University, on behalf of St. Eugene University, I am thanking you from my heart. Now I am leaving the session to you, ma'am. Welcome to the show. You can start, ma'am.
Thank you for the introduction. Good morning, Reverend Fathers, sisters, all the officials and my dear professors of St. John the Baptist University, Malawi, and St. Eugene University, Zambia. And my morning wishes to all the students and all other viewers. Before I get into the presentation, I just want to share a few words on today's topic. All these days, again from this webinar series, you might have gained quite knowledge of different skills which are needed for the enrichment of entrepreneurial ideas. Today is last but one day
maintain or improve other skills which you have learned up to yesterday. This self-esteem and self-trust is very essential for success. If you are having such qualities in you, you can very well develop other qualities or other
traits in you. These two means self-esteem and self-trust are regarded as the base or basement or foundation on which you can build, maintain or develop all the other skills you have learned so far. I mean, whether it is entrepreneurial traits or leadership traits or interview skills or employability skills and so on. So if we are following these, or if you are trusting ourselves, all the other qualities or all the other skills may come with us. With this foreword, let me get into the introduction. Let me get into the presentation. Sketch of this presentation is concept of self-esteem, then the influencing factors or the reasons affecting the self-esteem, and the types of self-esteem. Here we are dividing the self-esteem into two categories or two types of high self-esteem and low self-esteem, and the tips for improving the self-esteem. And the next part is self-trust, and we'll be seeing the tips for building self-trust. Self-esteem means the way we see and think about ourselves, which means acceptance of ourselves, the way we place, the value we place on ourselves. The word esteem means regard highly or favorably. If it is favorable regard, we treat ourselves high. And if it is unfavorable regard, we treat ourselves low. Thus, self-esteem means it's an overall evaluation of ourselves as human beings. Here, the factors or reasons influencing the self-esteem can see. First one is inner thinking. Your inner thinking or thoughts and perceptions highly influence the self-esteem of you. Here, how other people react to you. It plays an important or dominating role in building our self-esteem. All the experiences at home, our workplace, our community. Then illness, any diseases or any chronic diseases if you are having, or any disability or injury caused out of any accidents. These also have a dominating role on this self-esteem. Next one is age factor. It also affects one's self-esteem vulnerably. If the age increases, definitely some people think low about themselves. It automatically reduces the self-esteem. And the status or role in the society, it will also affect the self-esteem of ourselves. Then those who consistently receive overly critical whether it's negative or positive assessments from family and friends. All these influence the self-esteem. Then the signs of high self-esteem. Already I have told two types there. One is high or healthy self-esteem. Another one is low self-esteem. Now we'll see the signs of high self-esteem. People with high self-esteem possess the following characteristics. They like to meet new people. They don't worry about how others will judge them. They have the courage to express themselves or their needs. And their lives are enriched with each new encounter. They avoid dwelling on past or negative experiences. They express their needs. They feel confident always. And they have positive outlook on their life. They say no when they want to say. They don't be a yes person all the time. Whenever they want to say no, they used to say that all the time. They won't say yes, yes, yes and all. They see overall strengths and weaknesses and accept themselves. Neighbors and friends or relatives always want to keep such person around. Their ideas are met with interest because others want to hear what they have to say. They are magnets to positive opportunities. They'll grab the opportunities very fastly. They'll keep on thinking about the new opportunities and plan to reap the maximum optimal outputs or benefits out of it. People with high self-esteem have an I think I can attitude. Then we'll see the signs of low self-esteemed people. People with low self-esteem possess the following characteristics. These are completely different from that of the signs just we have seen. They don't believe in themselves. They see themselves failing before they begin. They have a hard time forgiving their mistakes and make themselves pay the price forever. They believe they can never be as good as they should be as others. They believe that others are better than them. They find difficult expressing their needs. They never express the things. They only focus on weaknesses and they never consider their strengths. Their properties are anger, depression, anxiety, shame and the like. They have negative outlook on life. They won't accept the positive feedback even. If someone is giving positive feedback, they won't accept that. They have a kind of trouble in saying no. They always say yes, yes, yes. They have struggled with confidence and they lack self-trust. They always try to hide themselves from others. They stop trying new things and refuse to take challenges. These are the signs of low esteemed people. And some more there, they are afraid to show their creativity because they'll be ridiculed. They are afraid of the comments of others. They are dissatisfied with their lives. They spend most of their time alone. They complain and criticize. They worry about everything and do nothing. People with low self-esteem have an I can't do it attitude. Those who are having high self-esteem believe that I can do it. Just opposite to that, these negative people feel. Then see how to have healthy self-esteem, how to develop or maintain high or healthy self-esteem. Try to take on challenges. This does not mean that you need to do everything yourself. As the part of the challenge, you can seek the help of others when we need it. So try something that you know will be difficult to achieve. It will definitely improve your self-esteem. Be positive always. Focus on your positive attributes. Here you can follow some practices. You can write down the positive things about yourself. You may be good at sports, or you might have heard nice things that your people or your neighbors or friends or relatives have said about you and the like. When you feel low, then you can recall these things and remind yourself that there is plenty of good things about you. By this regular effort or practice, you can start to feel more positive and can build your self-esteem. Next important thing is, don't compare yourself with others. Comparing yourself to others is a way to start feeling down or low or crummy. Try to focus on your own goals and achievements rather than measuring yours with others or measuring them against others. Then give yourself a break. You don't have to feel good about yourself all the time, because self-esteem varies from situation to situation, from day to day, from hour to hour, place to place. Some people feel relaxed and positive with friends and colleagues, but uneasy and shy with strangers. So we all have times when we feel down or find harder. Don't be hard or too critical. You can follow the example of some successful people. You can read the success stories of eminent persons. Avoid criticizing yourself to others. It will create a negative opinion of yourself. Have a high trust on you. Always trust yourself. Then talk yourself about the positive resolutions. Like, I can achieve my goal very shortly. I can achieve it very easily. I can write well. I can speak well. And the like. Always positive things. They will boost your skills and eventually improve the self-esteem. Then you can exhibit the good attitude with others. Then get plenty of rest. Make your work skills your own. And practice your talents. Always physically fit and learn new things and improve your personal relationships. Dress well. Always try to dress well. exhibit good attitude in the sense, be considerate to other people and be helpful always. Whenever and wherever needed, you can help others. Be sympathetic and empathetic. All these will make you feel pretty good about yourself. And make your work skills your own means. You must be ready to make your work skills uniqueness with you. Try to master variety of skills. It will automatically improve your self-esteem. Practice your talents means find out the talents in you and practice them frequently. And you can update the talents also. If you are practicing it day by day, you can multiply your talents also. New talents you can get. Then physical fitness means exercise is a great way to increase the physical fitness. According to research studies, exercises release a sort of feel-good hormones in you. So try to exercise more and keep your body fit. And try to learn new things means, you know, day by day you can learn new things, which others are not even aware of it. Next one is improving the personal relationships. Surround yourself with supportive people. Find people who make you feel good about yourself and avoid those who tend to trigger your negative things. So don't keep toxic people near to you. Always keep positive minded people or supportive people. These will automatically improve your self-esteem. Should dress well, because dressing will definitely increases your performance and it heightens the impressions about you. The way we feel about ourselves is often directly linked to your appearance. So dress your best and improve the self-esteem. It's that much powerful. When we are dressed well, we automatically feel better outside, and because of that, we are more likely to feel good in the inside also. So it supplies more energy to treat ourselves better. Exhibit your principles of behavior to others. If you are following some principles or policies in your life, you can exhibit or express it to others also. You can impart it to others also. And keep your promises and honor your commitments. And take responsibility for identifying your goals. Promises or commitments, in the sense, the promises we make to ourselves are most important ones. They are the ones, they pave a path to our hopes, dreams, or goals. You need to take self-promises as seriously as the obligations you take on for others. To make it happen, you can write it down. In small words, you can write. And make it visible around you. Wherever you go, you can keep that notes. And you can read. Then chart your daily actions. You can put schedules. I keep a progress card for that. There you can write how much I have fulfilled, how much commitments or promises I have fulfilled, how much I have to do it. Like that, you can measure your commitments and promises. Then keep it short. Keep it short in the sense, keep your commitments and the promises short. Reasonable commitments or reasonable promises you can give to others. and take responsibility for identifying your goals. If there is anything in your life that you personally are not happy with, don't ever say or blame it's because of the fault of others or because of the external factors or outside factors which are beyond you. That is not fair. Taking responsibility means you are in complete control of the results you create in your outside world. So take responsibility in such a way. Next tip is, be respectful towards yourself. Refuse to reject yourself. Recognize that you are the source of your own choices and actions. Surround yourself with supportive and self-contented people. How you are aware of the world? Why is it important to be aware of the world around you? When you learn to look around you, life becomes more interesting because you discover a new and fascinating world around you. So walk with purpose. Don't move blindly. Pass between things. Don't skip and cross. So stay, listen and go. Then seek honest feedback about yourself. Don't listen to the dishonest feedback of others. Don't listen to the dishonest person's feedbacks. Practice self-care. Don't forget to relax. Surround yourself with supportive people. How it is possible? Mental awareness is not something you can achieve solely on your own. Say, it is not a one-man goal. Surround yourself with people that are self-aware, strong and supportive. Seek out the company of good friends and good family members who are the self-contented ones. I should say something about the self-contented people. They live in the moment. They assume the world is generally good rather than evil. Not always blaming the government or politicians or rulers if any evil happens. So they don't blame others for that evil. They learn from their mistakes instead of dwelling on it. They won't recall it again and again. They'll move and learn from that mistakes. They tend to be optimistic rather than pessimistic. So always try to be with those contented people and don't be with discontented people. The important pillars of self-esteem. Here, six pillars of self-esteem there. First one is the practice of living consciously. Second one, the practice of self-acceptance. The practice of self-responsibility is the next one. And the next one is the practice of self-assertiveness. And next one is the practice of living purposefully. And the last one is the practice of personal integrity. We'll see one by one. First one is the practice of living consciously. Consciously, in the sense, you should live in alignment with your truth. Always you should live for the truth. You should mind the ego and your words. The greatest weapon you have for living a conscious life is to say no's more. Already we have seen in the tips. Say no to certain things you don't want to do. And don't try to live at the mercy of others. It's the foremost element of living consciously. If you are saying no's more, this is the perfect chance to demonstrate yourself or demonstrate your discipline and personal boundaries. And this is very much essential for building your self-esteem. And the second pillar is the practice of self-acceptance. You have to accept yourself. Don't try to refuse you or reject you. If you are accepting yourself, you are improving or trying to improve your or practice the high or healthy self-esteem in you. So try to acknowledge your reality. Own your outcomes or accept that struggle will always be part of your reality. Don't ever refuse seeing the struggles. Practice to take responsibility. Third one is self-responsibility. Here, how you will be responsible. Take responsibility always and don't blame the external factors. Next one is assertiveness. Assertiveness is the opposite behavior of aggressiveness. I have to improve or develop or inculcate many assertive behaviors. Properties of assertiveness you have to improve in yourself. For example, respecting others. And you can be firm, but you should be a kind person. And your voices. Your voices should not be neither too loud or too soft. Always practice middle range tone. The aggressive people may believe in loud, hard voice or very fast speech or speech pattern. Don't go for it. Practice the assertive speech patterns. So in order to maintain the self-esteem, try not to be an aggressive person, but be an assertive person. Next one is practicing to live purposefully. Find a mission for your purposeful life. Always you should live for a purpose and try to do or act today and not tomorrow. Don't postpone the things. Focus on one thing at a time. You should show determination to achieve. A kind of strong determination should be there in order to achieve the things in an effective manner. Next one is, last pillar is personal integrity. In order to improve your self-esteem, definitely you have to practice all these six qualities. These are given in a book written by Nathaniel Brandon. You can read this book also. The book heading is Six Pillars of Self-Esteem. Here, in order to improve the personal integrity or develop this character in you, practice personal integrity every day. Keep your promises or try to maintain the commitments or fulfill the commitments. Never betray others' trust on you. If anyone is believing you, don't betray them. If someone gives you confidential information, never disclose it to others. Be responsible, do what you say, and say what you do. Love your co-workers with appropriate conversation, with sympathy and empathy. If you are going to run a business, you can respect or love your subordinates or employees. If you are going to work in any other organizations, you can respect or love your co-workers. Then don't unreasonably don't sideline them. Treat them in an honest manner. Work together as a team that builds trust, and ultimately you can improve the character of personal integrity in it. And the second part is self-trust. Self-esteem is something different from self-trust. Self-trust means you have to trust yourself. Self-trust establishes self-confidence in you. If you are trusting yourself, it will help to build a confidence in you. Self-trust is related with your attitude, and self-confidence is related to your abilities, skills, talents, and everything. Here, you should allow others to trust you. If you trust yourself, then decision-making process will be very easier. Finally, you will be achieving your goals in an effective manner. Then some tips for building that self-trust. First one is be yourself. Second one, set reasonable goals. Third one, be kind to yourself. Then build on your strengths. Spend time with yourself and be decisive. First one is be yourself. If you fear how others will look at you or judge you, you might find it difficult to be yourself around other people. So don't afraid of others, or don't afraid of their judgments, comments, or negative feedbacks. Be yourself. Set reasonable goals means don't set too ambitious goals. If we don't reach our big goals, then we have to often experience failures and all. It can reduce your self-esteem. Reduce your self-trust, and finally your self-confidence will be affected. Then build on your strengths. Give importance to your strengths. Don't give importance to your weaknesses. Try to transform your weaknesses into strengths. Love yourself unconditionally, as you have your loved ones, as you are showing love to others. You should love yourself unconditionally. That builds trust and then confidence. Everyone is better at some things and worse at others. Trust yourself, do all kinds of things, and excel at all things possible. Spend time with yourself. Try to spend time for yourself. That time, pay close attention to your breath and body. That time, any thoughts or self-criticisms pass by and acknowledge them. You can find your faults or criticisms or feedbacks of others. You can recall them and acknowledge them. Then next time when you are doing things, you can correct it. So spend time for yourself. That time you can rectify all your mistakes. We lack trust in ourselves when we question our actions or decisions. So learn from the mistakes. Believe you'll make a better choice next time and move on. So try to follow these tips and build up your self-trust. Definitely your self-trust will be improving the character of self-confidence, and finally self-esteem will be improved. Let's review the things we have seen. Today is a simple topic only, very short topic. Let's review the things. Self-esteem comes from very experience of your life. How you view yourself affects everything you do in life. High self-esteem gives you a good feeling about yourself. So if you are developing the self-esteem, first, if you are developing, trusting yourself, then self-confidence will be creating, and finally, self-esteem will be increasing in a positive manner. That itself gives you a good feeling about yourself. So you can, going on, improve your self-esteem. Then low self-esteem distorts your view of yourself. It will decrease your view on yourself. So don't go for it. Try to follow all the tips we have seen now for improving the high or healthy self-esteem. Then your self-esteem can be improved. Then trust yourself, and it can help to boost your decision-making skills. Self-trust establishes confidence. If you trust yourself, then automatically your confidence will be increasing. You will be able to inculcate some or practice some talents or skills or develop some talents or skills in you. Then it will be improving, it will be increasing your confidence, and finally self-esteem will be improved. Then final thought is, you are an unique individual. No one else is like you in the whole world. This makes you special already. Our time in this world is limited. So make it happen for you, so you leave your mark in history. This quote, I want to conclude this. You are very powerful, provided you know how powerful you are. So you must know how much you are powerful, how much you are rich in these qualities, positive qualities. So try to build, develop, and maintain the self-esteem and self-trust in you. All the very best. Thank you. If you want to clarify anything, you can ask. Or you can leave your questions. One question is there in the chat box. What if you have a low self-esteem? Are there external factors that can help you trust yourself? In order to trust yourself, you have to improve your own qualities. Then only you can trust yourself. Then the next step is, if you are trusting yourself, your confidence will be increasing, and you can make way for others to trust you. No other external factors are necessary for improving your self-trust. Another question is, how can you know that this is my talent? You have to make a self-analysis how I am doing this thing? Can I shine in doing this particular work? If I am shining in this work, or if I am performing this work in an effective manner, from that itself you can infer that I am very talented in this. Then you can take it as a talent of yourself. Any other questions? Rajkumar sir. Rajkumar sir.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am. Dear participants, if you have the queries, just post your questions in the chat box.
Any other questions, sir?
Any other questions from the participant side? I hope the two participants, they got the answers from doctor. Any other questions from participants? In the chat box, I posted today's feedback form. The participants kindly fill your today's feedback form. It is activated now. If you have any queries, kindly post in the chat box. I hope the participants today, you learned what is the self-esteem and self-trust from Dr. Miji ma'am. Thank you so much for your patience, and thank you for your presentation, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Participants, we can see tomorrow is the last day of the whole 3 weeks webinar. Please be on the same time, and we will share the tomorrow's session link. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.